In the last video, we discussed what a topological space is and how to define it via open sets. In this video, we will see how to construct new topological spaces from given ones. We will start with the following problem. We are given a set X, a topological space Y, and a map from X to Y. Which topology on X can we choose such that F is continuous? F is continuous if the pre-image of every open set is open. So in the topology on X, every pre-image of an open set has to be open. So if we choose the discrete topology on X where every subset is open, the map F would be continuous. This is, however, not a very interesting solution. Instead, we could ask which topology with the least amount of open sets makes F continuous. Before we can answer this question, we first have to understand how different topologies relate to each other. So let's look at a simple example. The topologies on a two-element set. We have the trivial topology and the discrete topology. Additionally, there are two topologies in which just one one-point set is open. We can partially order these topologies by inclusion. If the topology T1 is included in T2, then T1 is called coarser than T2, and T2 is finer than T1. Now let's consider all topologies on a set X, which include a set B. This can, for example, be the set of all pre-images of open sets, like in our initial problem. And these topologies are once again partially ordered by inclusion. Here the maximal element is a discrete topology. We want to find a minimal topology, so a topology for which there are no coarser topologies. In principle, for a partial ordering, there can be multiple minimal elements, like this. In our case, however, we have a unique minimal element. It's given by the intersection of all topologies which include the set B. You can easily check by the axioms that this is again a topology. We say that this topology is generated by B. So we have proven that there is a unique coarser topology on X such that F is continuous. This is called the initial topology. More generally, we can consider multiple spaces YE and functions FE. Then we can once again find the coarser topology on X such that all functions are continuous. This topology is generated by the pre-images of all open sets in all spaces. Let's now look at some examples. First of all, we have this subspace topology. We are given a larger space X and take any subset A. Then the subspace topology on A is the initial topology induced by the inclusion. Here, the pre-image of an open set U is the intersection of U with A. So this intersection is open in A. The next example is a product topology. We are given two topological spaces X and Y and want to define a topology on the Cartesian product. This is the initial topology induced by the two projections. The topology is also generated by the products of open sets. The dual notion to the initial topology is a finite topology. Here, the domain is a known topological space. Once again, we want to find a topology such that F is continuous. We can, for example, take the trivial topology on X, which makes F continuous. So here we want to find the topology with the most amount of open sets, or more formally, the finest topology on X, which makes F continuous. This topology is called the final topology. A set is open in X if the pre-image is open in Y. Once again, we can generalize this to multiple topological spaces and functions. Here we have to take the intersection of all these topologies. Let's look at some examples. First of all, the disjoint union. We are given two topological spaces. Then the topology on the disjoint union is the final topology induced by the two inclusions. Intuitively, the disjoint union space consists of two copies of the space X and Y, which are disconnected from each other. Another example is a quotient topology. We are given a topological space Y and want to create a new space by gluing points in Y together. For example, given an interval, by identifying the endpoints, we should obtain a circle. Formally, we need to partition X on Y. So X is a collection of subsets which cover Y and don't overlap. Then all points in the same subset in the partition are glued together. So for this nine-element space, the resulting space would have 3 points corresponding to each subset. The quotient topology on X is a finite topology induced by the map Q, which maps each point of Y to the corresponding subset in the partition. In this example, the partition X consists of 1 2-element set and otherwise 1-element sets. So just the endpoints are identified. The resulting space is topologically equivalent to a circle. Equivalently to choosing a partition on Y, we can also choose an equivalence relation. Then the equivalence classes form a partition, and the map Q maps each point to its equivalence class. For example, if we take the equivalence relation on the unit interval generated by identifying 0 and 1, we obtain the same partition and get a space which is topologically equivalent to a circle. A more complex example is a construction of a torus. We start with a square and identify the opposing edges. Then you can prove that the resulting quotient space is topologically equivalent to a torus. Finally, let's study which maps into a space with the initial topology are continuous. The topology on X was generated by these sets. We only have to check whether the pre-image of the generating open sets are open. The pre-image of a pre-image is a pre-image of the composition. So we have that G is continuous if and only if all compositions are continuous. The initial topology is the only topology on X with this property. That's why we also call this the characteristic property of the initial topology. We can apply this to the subspace topology and the product topology. For the subspace topology, we get that a map into a subspace is continuous if and only if the same map into the larger space is continuous. For the product topology, we have that a map into a product is continuous if and only if both components are continuous. For the final topology, we also have a characteristic property. Here, a map from a space with a finite topology is continuous if and only if the composition with the functions which induce the finite topology are continuous. For the disjoint union, this means that a map on the disjoint union is continuous if and only if it's continuous on both components. For the quotient topology, we have that a map is continuous if and only if the composition with the quotient map is continuous. This means that if we have a map on X which maps equivalent elements to the same point, we can define F on the equivalence classes, and this map is also continuous. For example, the exponential function on the unit interval traces out the unit circle. The value at 0 and 1 is the same, so the map factors into a continuous map from the quotient space where we identify 0 and 1.